got dispatched for an elderly male with chest pain in Durbanville. On arrival at the patient's house, my patient managed to tell us exactly what we needed to know to figure out what is wrong with him. He listed the symptoms, the acute symptoms of a myocardial infarction. We told he's got chest pain, he's short of breath, he's got numbness to the arms, and he had a severe case of nausea. So, which can also be part of patients with acute MI. Assisted the patient onto the stretcher, starting doing our full treatment for acute myocardial infarction. En route to hospital, our patient deteriorated. Almost at hospital,
eh? I didn't panic when everything happened. When I see the patient is deteriorating, I didn't panic. I knew what to do, and then I knew what my partner wanted me to do. I trusted my mentor, so it was actually a good teamwork that happened. So.
We didn't expect the patient to become unresponsive. It was very instant. It's not like we had a deterioration period where you could see my patient's gradually deteriorating. It was a very instant moment. In these guys, everything happened with under an hour. The moment the patient loses his pulse, we immediately started chest compressions. So it was literally seconds, and we had circulation going for him. We had a defib in for him, and we even got ROSC within an hour. After we handed over in the resus unit, we moved him from our stretcher onto the bed. Our patient gained full consciousness. He managed to say thank you to the crews, and then they rolled him out the catheter.
I've had a lot of cardiac arrest cases, but then normally it's not a successful resuscitation. This was actually the first one, and then first in the ambulance.
That was a pretty great feeling. I really felt well done to us. Having my patient actually on the verge of death, and then seeing my patient going home, not to a aftercare or care facility, going home to his family and being able to talk normally, walk normally, no excessive complications. That was a great feeling.